اطلب العلم اخي فهو درب به نور به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور
اطلب العلم اخي فهو درب به نور به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور اطلب العلم اخي فهو درب به نور به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور
الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى اما بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The fourth narration we will be discussing has been narrated by Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. He said, "By him who split the seed and created life, the unlettered Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave me a promise that no one but a believer would love me and none but a hypocrite would nurse a grudge against me." We learn from this narration the great virtue for Amirul Mu'mineen Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. This narration is an inspiration for loving and following in the footsteps of Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. Similarly, this narration issues a great warning to those who harbor ill against him. Loving Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu is a sign of faith. This love, though, should be true and sincere. Sincere love by way of following his ways and character brought to us through authentic narrations. As for those who make him an agency of their lies and erect their faith on this, they truly hold a deep grudge against him, which results in hypocrisy. Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani writes, "If it is argued that this narration, which speaks of great virtue with regards to Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, necessitates his khilafah, then it would necessitate the same for the Ansar. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the same regarding them, only a believer loves them and only a hypocrite hates them. Allah loves he who loves them and Allah detests he who harbors ill feeling towards them." The Sahaba radiallahu anhum were in agreement that the first three khulafa enjoy a higher status. Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah narrates the following on the authority of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. "We considered Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu as peerless, and then Umar radiallahu anhu, and then Uthman radiallahu anhu, coming next to him in superiority. And then we would not differentiate between the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam." Another narration from Muhammad bin Ali bin Abi Talib, who is famously known as Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya, reads as follows. "I said to my father, which of the people after the Messenger of Allah is best? He replied, Abu Bakr. I then said, who comes next? He said, Umar. I was then afraid of asking him who came next, and he might mention Uthman radiallahu anhu. So I said, you are next, O my father. He said, I am only a man among the Muslims." One may ask, what is the connection between loving Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu and faith? Similarly, what links hate towards him with hypocrisy? The answer to this is, the books of Ahadith are replete with narrations that portray the immense strength Ali radiallahu anhu lent to Islam, together with his scrupulousness and sublime character. When one therefore loves him, he is showing love for these acts and accomplishments, which translate as a sign of faith. On the other hand, if one shows disdain for him, he is showing disdain for his accomplishments in the field of Islam, which can only be understood as hypocrisy. The above criteria of love equaling faith is with respect to all the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, as is understood by the narration expounding the virtue of the Ansar. Only a believer loves them and only a hypocrite hates them. Allah loves he who loves them and Allah detests he who harbors ill feeling towards them. If all the Sahaba radiallahu anhum enjoy the same virtue, why is Ali radiallahu anhu being referred to specifically? This was due to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam having knowledge of the different factions that will appear during his khilafah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had foreseen and prophesied certain details of this as well. This narration was to make the Ummah understand the relevance and legitimacy of his Khilafah, together with warning those who would oppose him. An important question which needs to be addressed: will those Sahaba who fought against Ali radiallahu anhu at Jamal be a reflection of the narration, and none but a hypocrite would nurse a grudge against me? The answer is that the Sahaba radiallahu anhum were all authorities in Islamic law, mujtahideen, searching for the truth. A true mujtahid will not be taken to task for a conclusion he comes to, this being a principal law of the Sharia. The position taken by the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah with regards to the disputes of Sahaba radiallahu anhum is of adopting silent neutrality, as both parties were mujtahideen. Let us look at the meaning of the following narration. Abdullah bin Buraydah radiallahu anhu narrates from his father. The Prophet ﷺ sent Ali to Khalid to retrieve the booty whilst I disliked Ali. When we reached the Prophet ﷺ, I mentioned that to him. He said, "O Buraydah, do you dislike Ali?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Do not dislike him, for he deserves more than that from the booty." Rasulullah ﷺ did not brand Buraydah radiallahu anhu a disbeliever or the like thereof, nor did he instruct Ali radiallahu anhu to insult or kill him. This narration proves that mere dislike based on disagreements does not constitute hypocrisy. Dislike based on matters of deen and its spreading will constitute hypocrisy. None of those Sahaba radiallahu anhum who disagreed with Ali radiallahu an ever criticized his contributions to deen or services to Islam. They recognized his virtue and even praised him on other occasions. They were brothers in faith in this world, and in the year after they will be, as Sayyiduna Asadullah Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu himself stated they would be. ونزعنا ما في صدورهم من غل إخوانا على سرر متقابلين. Brothers in faith, beloveds of Allah, all relishing in the eternal gardens of paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instill love for all of them in our hearts and unite us with them in the everlasting abode of Jannah. Wa akhiru da'wana أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
اطلب العلم أخي فهو درب به نور، به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور. اطلب العلم أخي فهو درب به نور، به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور.